So we pay our respects to all those men and women in our armed forces, as well as all the first responders, and our hopes that everybody comes home safely. And the pledge.
The pledge of allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
According to the provision of the Open Public Meetings Law and the Open Public Meetings Law, the Brunswick Tribune and Bar Harbor newspapers, as well as posted on the Middlesex County website, as well as on the bulletin board in Middlesex County Administration Building, at least 48 hours in advance of this meeting, which shall be entered into the minutes. Madam Clerk, roll call, please.
County Commissioner Esposito Barber?
Here.
County Commissioner Kenny?
Here.
County Commissioner Cockle?
Here.
County Commissioner McCollum?
Here.
County Commissioner Nara?
Here.
County Commissioner Tamara?
Here.
County Commissioner Director Rio?
And correspondence?
Each commissioner has been provided with a list of correspondence received by the clerk's office since our last meeting. This correspondence has been filed in the office of the clerk of the board of directors.
Is there a motion to accept the correspondence?
So moved.
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Minutes for approval?
Minutes of November 13, 2023, regular meeting at 7:00 p.m.
Is there a motion to approve the above minutes?
Second.
Roll call?
County Commissioner Esposito Barber?
Yes.
County Commissioner Kenny?
Yes.
County Commissioner Cockle?
Yes.
County Commissioner McCollum?
Abstain.
County Commissioner Tamara?
Yes.
County Commissioner Deputy Director Nara?
Yes. And reports of commissioners. County Commissioner Esposito Barber?
Thank you, Deputy Director Nara. During this holiday season, show how much we care about helping feed Middlesex County residents who are struggling and in need of food. By setting aside just one item of food a day, the next couple of weeks, your food collection can be help others so many different ways. Donations can be dropped or replenished at 28 Kennedy Boulevard in East Brunswick, or by calling at 732-729-0880 to arrange a pickup. At this year's State Senior Citizen Art Contest, Middlesex County artists received the first place, second place, third places, and two honorable mentions. Congratulations to all winners. We are so proud of our seniors. And that concludes my report, Deputy Director Nara.
Thank you, Commissioner. Commissioner Kenny.
Thank you, Deputy Director. As the year comes to a close, just an update on our ADA curb ramp project. It's concluding for this year. Approximately 250 curb ramps have been replaced to meet current standards for both the motor and visually impaired. The program includes ramps in 11 different municipalities, and the project cost is approximately $2.5 million. The other thing is just happy Hanukkah to anybody who celebrates. That's all I have, Deputy Director. Thank you.
Thank you. Commissioner Cockle?
Thank you, Deputy Director. The Middlesex County Purchasing Office held the 2023 annual online auction this past October. Included in the auction were 89 vehicles and pieces of equipment that were either damaged, past their useful life, or no longer needed by the county. There were also 179 lots of office furniture, equipment, and supplies, and other miscellaneous items. The total proceeds realized was $449,157.98. In April of 2023, the county also
with NAACP in Brunswick Area Branch on December 28th, starting at 4:30 on the third floor of the exhibition space of the Brunswick Performing Arts Center. This afternoon will be filled with performances, community lighting of the Canara, delicious food, and children's crafts. From the Office of Workforce and Career Development, the Pathways to Recovery Program is a free employment program for Middlesex County residents age 18 and up that assists individuals who have been impacted by the opioid epidemic in providing education, training, and assistance in finding gainful long-term employment. Visit the county website for details. Life Science Career Expo. On Tuesday, January 9th, the Office of Workforce and Career Development, in collaboration with the New Jersey Department of Labor, will be hosting a Life Science Career Expo at the New Jersey Performing Arts Center from 12 to 2. This event is for mid-senior level science professionals with industry sector experience and will feature actively hiring life science employers. For additional information, interested employers should contact employers@county.middlesex.nj.us. And job seekers and professionals can visit the county website or email workforce@county.middlesex.nj.us. From the Office of the Superintendent of Schools, I'm happy to announce that Claremont Avenue Elementary School in Colonia was recently designated as one of only six schools in New Jersey as a national blue ribbon school. Deputy Director, that concludes my report.
Thank you. Commissioner Tenaro.
Thank you. Your turn. For those who already have cabin fever or just don't like the cold weather, there's a lot for exploring our park system. Enjoy the quiet, serene natural surfaces, trails, and the John A. Phillips Preserve, or the paved pathway of the Middlesex County Greenway. If you appreciate bird watching, check out the Davidson Mill Pond Park. Our tennis and pickleball courts are open all year round, with many of our courts offering push-button lighting or evening light. The family ice skating rink in the beautiful Roosevelt Park is again open for the 2023-24 season. Beautiful outdoor facility has a lot to offer, including open skating sessions, skate rentals, skating lessons, and private rink rentals. If you and your family are interested in learning to ice skate, I recommend checking out our ice skating lessons. They're available at all skill levels and begin on this Saturday, December 9th. Lessons run for 7 weeks, include skate rentals, weekly lessons, and practice time. Remember to call the weather hotline 732-745-4484 before heading out, and visit our website for more information about the rink, including hours of skating lessons and pricing. And that concludes our report.
Thank you. And from the Department of Public Safety and Health, as the holidays are rapidly approaching, I'd like to remind you all about some simple holiday tips. When decorating, make certain you utilize UL-approved electrical cords and devices. Please don't overload your circuits. And if you decorate with live trees, wreaths, etc., please ensure they are watered and kept away from flames. Don't leave open flames unattended, whether they are candles or when you're cooking. And please take the extra time to get to gatherings, parties, or family celebrations. Remember, if celebrating, do so responsibly or use designated drivers, mass transit, or services like Uber or Lyft or taxis. Law enforcement is very active during this holiday season with DWI checkpoints, and there are a number of municipalities in our county who've been awarded special grants to have enhanced safety and enforcement checkpoints, so I would advise everyone to be very careful. If traveling, be cognizant of your surroundings and report any suspicious activity to the appropriate authorities. We want everyone who's either visiting or living in this county to be able to celebrate the holidays safely and do so healthily. And I also want to, two things. I just like to encourage our wonderful residents of this beautiful county to continue to be generous to those members of our communities who may be less fortunate. I know during the Thanksgiving holidays, so many of you were generous-hearted and opened up your wallets and your cabinets and really tried to make sure that other families and other people had access to good food during the Thanksgiving holidays. I just ask you all to remember, it's getting much colder. So it's not just food that many of our fellow citizens need, but also warm clothing, bedding, the like. So I just all ask you to reach deep and continue to be generous, as I know our county is known to be. And I also would like to wish everyone who celebrates a very healthy and happy Hanukkah. So, Mr. Kelso, are there any resolutions to be added?
There are none.
Any resolutions to be amended?
There are none.
Any resolutions to be held?
There are none.
Any resolutions to be voided?
There are none.
I'd like to open the public discussion on resolutions listed on this agenda and resolutions only. Anyone from the public?
Move to close the public portion.
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Mr. Kelso, are there any items to be removed from the consent agenda and voted separately?
Excluding resolutions 23-1661, 23-1662, 23-1635, and 23-1636
to be voted upon
separately. Do I have a motion? Motion to adopt the consent agenda.
Second.
Roll call.
County Commissioner Esther Barber?
Yes.
County Commissioner Kenny?
Yes.
County Commissioner Cobble?
Yes.
County Commissioner McCollum?
Yes.
County Commissioner Tamara?
Yes.
County Commissioner Deputy Director Nara?
Yes.
Now would be appropriate to consider the resolutions which were excluded by Commissioners Column, and those are resolutions 23-1661 and resolution 23-1662.
May I have a motion?
Second.
All those in favor, roll call.
County Commissioner Esmeralda Barber?
Yes.
County Commissioner Kenny?
Yes.
County Commissioner Cobble?
Yes.
County Commissioner McCollum?
Present.
County Commissioner Tamara?
Yes.
County Commissioner Deputy Director Nara?
Yes.
And now would be appropriate to consider the resolutions which were excluded by Deputy Director Nara, and those are resolutions 23-1635 and 23-1636.
May I have a motion?
Second.
All those in favor, roll call.
County Commissioner Esmeralda Barber?
Yes.
County Commissioner
yes.
Kenny? County Commissioner Cockle?
Yes.
County Commissioner McCollum?
Yes.
County Commissioner Tamara?
Yes.
County Commissioner Deputy Director Nara?
Present and not voting? So I'd now like to open the public discussion. Anyone who would like to be heard in public session?
Second.
Roll call? Oh, I'm sorry. Is there a voice vote on this? All those in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed or abstained? So may I have a motion to adjourn?
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Meeting adjourned.